Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Programmers develop applications. Applications deal with data. Therefore, we need to understand data. Knowing the structure of the data and what actions we can perform on that data will be critical to the programming process. To begin our journey exploring the types of data we can work with within the Python programming language, first of all, we introduce the idea or concept of data types. So plain and simple, data types or data type is a particular kind of data item. Instinctively, we probably already have a basic understanding of this. Loosely speaking, a word, hello, that's not a number, that's a word. And a number, 100, well, that's a number. So again, loosely speaking, we already understand the concept of data types because we already have a way of categorizing different aspects of what we work with and what we know already without moving into the programming world. In the world of the Python programming language, there are a number of pre-existing built-in data types that we can utilize within our program. Just going back to what we mentioned earlier, a word and a number. Here in the Python programming language, we can define different values utilizing one of these many data types. So for example, a word, hello, that would be classified or would be considered a string data type. If, for example, we had the number 100, well, that would be a whole number. So therefore, in Python, we would probably categorize that as an integer. If we were working with a number with a decimal point within our application, then that is probably more likely going to be a float being a number which can have a decimal point. So we can see from this list, in actual fact, there are a lot of different types of data that we might work with within our Python and Django application. Now, this isn't actually the whole list, because in actual fact, we can also build our own data types. Remember, this is just the built-in data types. So Python comes with a set of data types which we can utilize. And there's good reasons for that. It saves us time, for one thing, having to define our own data types. And these are some of the more common types of data that you're going to want to work with within your application. Now, these data types, they can be categorized and summarized into these categories here. So the types of data that we're going to be working with within our application might be numeric, so numbers, different types of numbers. We have a dictionary, a Boolean, true or false, a set, or a sequence type. So a sequence type might in fact be a string. Remember, a word, we were categorizing a word, hello, as a string, and a string is a sequence type. So we have a value. So a value here can be the number one, it can be a word, for example. So in order for our value to conform to or be considered one of the data types, it needs to conform to the rules of that particular data type. Take, for example, a string. In order for our data to be a string, it needs to be a sequence of characters or Unicode characters. So that does mean that the number 1 or 2 or 100 could be a string or it could also be a number. It depends on how we want to work with that specific data. If we wanted, for example, to calculate a number, then we probably couldn't use a string. So if we had the number 100, and then we told Python that is going to be a string, then we couldn't potentially then perform calculations on it because it's a string. So the string data format will also potentially prevent different types of operations being performed on that particular data type. Whereas, for example, if we had the number 100 and we would tell Python that that number should be part of or should be the data type integer, then we could then potentially perform operations on it, for example, mathematical operations. So the integer data type is a positive or negative whole number without the fraction or decimal. If we did want to work with data, numbers, values that had a floating point or a decimal point, then potentially we would need to ensure that that data type or that data or that value was then assigned to the float data type. As we can see, the float data type is a real number with floating point representation. So ultimately, data types are defined by the values that they can take. So for example, like we said, an integer data type, we couldn't, for example, use a string as an integer data type because the integer data type rules define that it needs to be a whole number. The value needs to be a whole number. We've already touched on this point here. So data types have predefined operations that can be performed on them. So as I discussed earlier, let's imagine we had the number 100 and the number 50, and then we would assign them an integer data type. So they are both now integer data types. We could perform certain operations on these numbers. For example, we could add, we could subtract, we could divide these numbers, we could multiply these numbers. So we can do that because they are of a specific data type, an integer. If, for example, we were to assign the number 100 as a string, and then the number 150, if we were to convert that into a string, we couldn't necessarily then perform the same operations. We couldn't necessarily divide or multiply these numbers with the outcome being a number. Okay, so that was a very trivial type of example. But if we were just to scale that up to all the different built-in types, we can get an idea that these built-in data types, depending on the type of data that we'll work with, will define what we can do with that data. And that's a really important aspect when we're developing our application. We need to know what type of data that we're working with in order for us to effectively create an application that can perform operations that is required. Now, sometimes we need to take integers and we need to turn them into strings to perform certain operations. And sometimes we're presented with data that is a string initially that we need to convert into other data to perform other operations. So these type of data types are very important to understand, and we need to understand what our data is and what data we're working with within our application and how to work with those particular data types. Data types might seem quite a trivial topic to begin with, but at least in my opinion, once you learn in your programming language how to master working with different types of data and what actions you can perform on those data, I feel as though programming does become a lot easier.